And Lord, we lift that your name. With our hearts filled with praise, be exalted, O Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Oh, we lift you up, Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Oh, Lord, we worship you, Lord. Lord, we lift up your name. With our hearts full of praise, with our hearts full of praise, we exalt it, O Lord, my God. Hosanna in the highest. Glory to the King of Kings.
Glory, glory, glory to the King of Kings.
Oh, we worship you, Jesus.
Glory, glory, glory to the King of Kings.
Oh, we lift up our worship to you, Lord.
Lord, we lift up your name. With our hearts full of praise, be exalted, O Lord, high God. Hosanna to the highest.
Jesus, Jesus, you're the King. You're the King of my life, Lord.
Jesus, 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 you're the King of Kings. Lord, we lift up your name. With our hearts full of praise, be exalted, O Lord, our God. Hosanna in the highest.
Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest. In the highest, O Lord. Jesus, we worship you, Lord. Come and take your place in the highest, Lord. There is none like you, so beautiful, Lord. Jesus, we worship you. We bless your name, Lord. Oh, we worship you, Lord. Sing, you're my friend again.
You're my friend, and you are my brother,
even though you are my King, Lord.
I love you more than any other, so much more than anything.
You alone are my strength, Lord. Oh, you alone are my strength, my shield. To you alone love you, Lord.
And I love you more than gold or silver. Only you can satisfy.
You alone are the real joy giver. You more than gold or silver.
I love you more than gold or silver.
Only you can satisfy, Lord. You are the true, real joy giver, Lord.
You alone are the real.
You're the apple of my eye, Lord. God's desire, Lord. You are the apple of my eye, Lord. I love you more than anything, Lord.
Turn your word of God to book of Romans chapter 4 verse 17. Let us see what the Lord is going to speak to us today through his word. As it is written, I have made you a father of many nations, in the presence of him whom believed God, who gives life to the dead and calls those things which do not exist as though they did. Amen. The cream of this word, we are in the presence of God who calls those things does not exist as they do. Amen. Hallelujah. Are you excited? And we are standing today in the presence of the God who is telling, I am the God who calls those things does not exist or does not there as if they are there. Hallelujah. Amen. In Tamil, it's beautiful. I don't know how many of you can understand. I think the Spirit of God will guide you. இல்லாதவைகளை இருப்பவை போல் அழைக்கிற தேவன். Our God is the God who calls those things does not exist, but he calls as if they do. Hallelujah. Being the children of Most High God, the children of the God who created the heaven and earth, we do have the privilege to call those things does not exist as if they do. And today, with the help of the Holy Spirit, I am going to show to you and how mighty and powerful and the authority that you and me receive from the throne room of grace. Let us look into the Lord in prayer. Our most loving, gracious Heavenly Father, Lord, thank you, Lord, for this brand new day, Lord. The day filled with your grace and mercy. It is all about you, Jesus. Lord, we love you, Lord. Lord, who am I that you are mindful of me, O Lord? Even the fellow like me, you could rise from the death and keep it here, O Lord, to use as your mouthpiece, Lord, I indebted for you, Lord Jesus. Lord, as I stand here as an empty vessel, fill me, Holy Spirit of God, so that today, including me, each and every one of us, we will see power of thy glory being manifested in the temple of the high God, O Lord Jesus. Lord, we believe and we realize today the many of areas in our life, O Lord, the influence of this world, we have slid down away from the way of you, O Lord. But today, as you are going to speak through your powerful word, the word going to align our ways, O Lord, put us back on track. And we believe today there is going to be a signs, wonders, and miracle for your glory. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Today, you know, many people might have told many things about you and me. They might have declared some words to you. They might have spoken something to you. Or they may profess something into your life. But here I am to tell you, today what matters the most is what God says about you. Hallelujah. Amen. It is not about people say about you. It is not about that some preachers say about you. It is not about your fellow people or the workplace or the home says about you. But it is all about what God says about you. And Isaiah 55:9, the word of God says, my thoughts are higher than your thoughts. Hallelujah. Isn't it amazing what God thinks about us? The word of God says, he's telling we are his workmanship. We are his masterpiece. And we have been created fearfully and wonderfully. As he creates each and every one of us, he fills us with his glory, make us worthy to be kept in his presence. Hallelujah. That is a God. Because we are the chosen generation, royal priesthood, and holy nation. If you realize what we are in the Lord, we will never give up. If you realize today what we have been created for, we will never bow before a man, but only bow before God, who created heaven and earth. Amen? Today, even as the word says in Romans 4:17, we have a God who calls those things does not exist as though they do. I just want to, each and every one of you, take that word into your spirit strongly. So when you go into such a situation and you can declare the word of God to that situation, hallelujah, you will not talk about the situation, but you will talk to the situation. Amen. And you will rise up beyond the situation and you will say, my Redeemer lives. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. That's what all about Jesus today we are going to talk. And today I want to see and I want to meditate upon those mighty men of God from the word of God and how they could call those things did not exist as though they did. Amen. And starting with the God himself, the Genesis chapter 1:3, the word of God says, and when God, the verse 2, when God has seen, you know, the verse 1, God created heaven and earth, and the verse 2 says, there is a darkness over the earth. Probably, that is the time the fallen angel Lucifer being kicked out of the heaven, when he fall on the earth become and verse 3, the God says, let there be light. And there was light. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Our God who called those things does not exist as they do. When there was no light, God said, let there be light. And there was light. Hallelujah. So we are worshiping that God. He called those things though does not exist as they do. Turn your Bible to 2 Kings chapter 3, verse 17 and 18. Can someone read? It is an Awesome, mighty word of God, powerful promise of God. 2 Kings chapter 3, verses 17 and 18. Someone can read, please. Amen. You will see neither wind nor. Amen. Go ahead, please. The valleys will be filled with water. Amen. Amen. You, your cattle, and other animals will drink. Go ahead. Can you read 18?
This is an easy thing in the eyes.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Can someone say hallelujah? You know, the Elisha, when the Ammonites rose against the children of God, the king Jehoshaphat called the prophet Elisha. And what he received from the God, and he is saying, make ditches all over the valley. The man believe what is not there. He want to call those things did not exist as they do. And someone must have asked him also, when there is no wind and no rain, why should we need to make ditches all around the valley? And today, beloved in Christ, I want to see if you start seeing the invisible thing and you can do the impossible. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because we do have a God who called those things does not exist as they do. He called it. Hallelujah. And when they said, Lazarus, come out. 4 days. After 4 days, what you can expect? After 4 days, someone died. It may be stinking and you can't go nearby, I can tell you. But Jesus learned from his father to call those things does not exist as if they do. Hallelujah. So the verses in 2 Kings 3, 17 and 18 says, when Elisha the prophet called the people and told, make ditches all around the valley. And he said, thus says the Lord of hosts, there won't be wind and there won't be rain. But what is going to happen? The valley will be filled with water. You, your cattle and your animal will drink and satisfied. And verse 18 says, this is very easy thing for the Lord. Hallelujah. For our God, nothing is impossible. I don't know today what is your situation and what is the need in your life, but we are worshiping a God who called those things does not exist as they do. If at all you want me to give a heading to my sermon today, what God is speaking to us, we can give it. God called those things does not exist as they do, so can we do. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Get it to that into your spirit. And I will tell you, I will assure your life will never the same again. Hallelujah. Now he's saying, verse 18, this is very easy thing. Because the God whom we worship is a God who is a creator of the heaven and earth. Is there anything difficult for the God? No. We believe in him. And nothing is impossible for God. And every nature, every creation, subject to the God who created. Amen? Because the creations subject to creator except the human being. I think in some extent you have to agree. But we are a special people. We are subject. But today, you know, all the chaos. You know, sometimes really I really we don't know where the world today you and me live is heading to. You know what happened? Sometimes back, I think when I was in another country, it is very thought-provoking. What you were seeing, something, you know, very weird, and today became common. And God forbid, We don't know what all things we are going to see. But you and me looking for the Lord's coming to be caught up in His glory. You know, when I was in the country, I happened to go one of the saloons. I don't know. Many of my experiences happens in the saloon and the, you know, hair cutting saloon. You know what happened? Where I was there, that country where there's a prayer. When the prayer happened, they have to close the shop. Immediately you have to close the shop. It's nice. God bless them. So now, when I was there, usually what happened when you are in the supermarket, as soon as the prayer starts, because they rever their God, so they're immediately they have to close it. And there are people, they even backslide, they will, from the back door they will sell. And they will get a good penalty for it. Now, the point I am trying to say, I was there in the saloon, and he started cutting, from the side. Now you can think about it. Suddenly, they announced a prayer. Now, my heart really beating like you can imagine. And you know what is going to happen, because you are already there for 10 plus years. What will happen? He told, sorry, I can't help you. Now, I have to go for a prayer. Now, you can think of one side is cut like that, Then he's telling, I need to go. What should I do? I told, sorry, whatever you want, you can do it. But the maximum what favor I can do is, I will lock the door, be inside, till I come another 30 minutes. I told, now you have nothing left choice than that. I cannot come out with that, half done work. Then even I was so disappointed, depressed. In the dark room, you cannot put light, because from outside somebody see the light, they will see how come there is something going on there. In the darkness, I was there for 30 minutes. It is really hurting. Now, I don't know what all things you said, even I don't remember what all things. That when he came and continued the work, I could come out. Now, what the point I am trying to make, the other day I was in the mall, I was working in the Dubai mall. I have seen people with the half done work. I was wondering which barber shop they sent outside. Come on, you started, you finish it. Even some people, when they extend up writing their names on the head only. Hello, there are better place to write, And they want to make that barbers more competent, to do all the alphabets writing there only. You can imagine, I think you might have witnessed. Now the point I am trying to make this morning, one time we felt the shame, it became a style today. Half cooked, half done. God forgive those people. And what I'm trying to say this morning, you and me, as the light of God shine upon us in the world of darkness and confusion, chaos, we need to set an example for those people. It's not like if someone is opening two, button, you tell, I am not, nevertheless, I will open four button. You can have the gadget, here. How many gadgets you put? I really don't understand all those gadgets, what they do for them. The word of God says, those who don't know the God, they will pierce themselves. When they not only physically pierce, and the devil is so happy, and then you see this fellow, nothing left only to pierce. Hello, beloved, 2,000 years before Jesus went on the cross of Calvary, died for you and me, you don't have to pierce anymore yourself. If you still do it, it's a dead work. God has not called us to do those things. Amen. So, never get surprised. Yesterday's shame became today's style. Today's shame can become tomorrow's style. Because the word of God said in the last days, you will see all this about perversion. Almost, it's very sad to say, almost 30 plus countries so far approved, legalized the gay marriage. God has not called to the man and woman to marry. Even so-called man of God says, who am I to, you know, to judge them? Hello, we are not judge them, but we need to say the word of God clear and bold. And we are the light of the world, and we are the salt of the earth. Don't compromise with the word of God. And we will be then the partaker of the judgment what God may bring upon us. And you and me have been called with a special purpose. Hallelujah. No, God loves the sinners. The word of God says that Jesus came to save and seek the lost. But you hate the sin. He hate the sin. Hallelujah. Amen. And he hate the sin. And he cannot love the sin because our God is holy. So as he is holy, you and me are holy. And today, only our prayer is, Lord, as your word is divinely deposited in our spirit, in some of the areas we have been, Lord, deviated, disaligned. And today, your word is going to align us, O Lord Jesus, so that we will walk in your ways, O Lord Jesus. We will not conform to the world, but we will be, you know, transformed according to your word, which has a life and power to renew our mind and transform our heart. And we know we will never the same again. Hallelujah. So, as we have seen, the Elisha the prophet, when he received from the God, and he could speak to the even the natures. Amen. He could call those things didn't exist as if they do. Amen. When he said, let there be rain, there was rain. And our God is the God who can bring rain without clouds. Our God doesn't work according to the worldly logic. You know, people say, no, it is not logic. Our God is not limited to logic. Hallelujah. And he knows what he is doing. And every subject of his is subject to him only. Amen. Hallelujah. And the next one we want to see from Joshua chapter 6 verse 2. Joshua, see, I have given Jericho into your hand. Hallelujah. Now still Jericho not came to Joshua and his people. But God said to Joshua, see, I have given Jericho and the mighty valor of mighty man and his kings, along with his kings. Amen. So the God who called those things does not exist as they do. When God spoke to Joshua, he believed it. The word of God says the Abraham believed God and that counted righteousness unto him. Hallelujah. You know what is happening in your life and my life? To believe, you don't need faith. Amen. So what is happening is happening. So some people say, like, you know, what is happened, it'll happen. What is happening, it'll happen. What will happen, that will happen. No, we are not those people. We are the destiny changers. Hallelujah. We are a Joshua generation. And we receive from God and we speak to even the natures, and the natures has to obey. And the word of God says, Elijah is a man just like you and me, when he said, let not there be a rain for 3 years, and there was not rain. He is not someone special came fall from above. The word of God says, he is a man just like you and me, but when he earnestly prayed, or when he declared in the name of Lord, whatever he said, it came to pass. None of his word fell on the ground. Hallelujah. Today, even I don't know what is your need. Because those who believe, they are you and me, that mighty God is in our midst. And he is the God who brings death to the life. He gives hope to the hopeless. who give health to the sick, who deliver one who is in bondage, who save is who is in the slavery. Hallelujah. So we are worshiping that God. And no matter whatever need, what stinging situation you are in and through, but our God is an awesome God. He's a mighty God. Hallelujah. Amen. So even John chapter 11:41, you know, 11:41 talk about Jesus calling the dead Lazarus out of tomb. Now Jesus, you know, if at all Lazarus died, and even the word of God, the few verses before that, word of God says, looking at to him and the people crying around him, Jesus wept. Jesus cried. He was moved by compassion. He got delayed while reaching there, but Jesus knew everything is under control. What is impossible for man is possible for God. And he believed his heavenly Father can do a mighty miracle. Even the fourth day after death. You know, sometimes for a few hours you can say he may went into some, you know, some small losing the breath or something. But after 4 days, and you can think what will happen to the body which has been even buried. And I am sure that after 4 days, no one can even stand. Sometimes do happen, you know, some of the medical legal cases. I remember when we were in working in a hospital, there's a truck and all the driver along with that went to a very valley, the deep valley. After 4 or 5 days, they couldn't trace out the neither truck nor the person. Then through the helicopter, they could, you know, locate that valley, and they brought that 2 or 3 bodies into the hospital. Believe me, all over Worms. Now, because of the medical legal case, they cannot bury without, you know, whatever you call postmortem or whatever. They need a legal or medical report to close the file. When they brought, and the whole medical team was running away because they are telling, no, you have to do is make some reports. Now, even doctor is also a human being. The medical department is a human being. You know, to telling is easy, but to go into that body which is been, you know, stinking and worms all over, and it is been, they have put all sort of fragments, antiseptic, whatnot, you pour out, but still, you can't go nearby. That's what happened. But Jesus, the verse 11:41 of John says, when they asked them to move the stone, and he looked at the heaven and said, Father, thank you that you heard me. It means, what did he do? He believed. He called those things did not exist as though they did. Jesus is the perfect man and perfect God. And at that point of time, he did not do as a God. He did as a human being like you and me. But he understood one secret, that his God is a God of creation. He's a God of restoration. The God of supernatural power. Hallelujah. As he is aligned with his God, as he obeyed by his commandments, whatever God could do, he understood he could do the same thing. Hallelujah. So the secret is, what the relationship do we have today with our God? Hallelujah. That's what makes the difference. Now, so we have been seeing from the scriptures how God or godly people call those things didn't exist as they did. There's nothing but the supernatural provision. Hallelujah. Because the word of God says, those who knows their God, they will do a mighty exploit. Amen. Those who knows their God will do a mighty exploit. Hallelujah. See, the word of God says, Hebrews 11:6. The word of God says, it is impossible to please God without faith. And you know, none of us can say that we don't have faith. But the God by creation only puts certain amount of faith into our being. Amen? Can I say once again? The amount of faith you and me received, that is a creation. But doubting that faith is called unbelief. The doubting that faith is called unbelief. No matter, maybe there is your situation or circumstances that make you or made you or the people around you influence you to doubt that faith. But Jesus time and time again say, believe me and you will see the glory of God. Hallelujah. And those who are believe in the God and they can do a mighty things for the Lord's work. Amen. So we have seen there are the list go on and on and on when we see the God's people, how they, you know, done the mighty miracle. Even if you say the New Testament, how even, you know, when the Peter passed by his shade, the people have been healed. Amen. We could see because when where there is no healing, they can call healing. And when there is a lame fellow was lying there, and they said, silver and John and Peter said to him, silver and gold I have none, but in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk. And he was a lame man by birth, and his muscles weary, and there is nothing, no strength to stand. But even they could call. Those things did not exist as they in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. No, so the God's love is so amazing. So we are going to meditate in the 3 points, how we are going to, or 3 or 4 points quickly, and how we are going to call those things does not exist in our life as they do. You may be weary, you may be disappointed, or you may be depressed by the people, circumstances, or situation. But today, God is going to empower each and every one of us. As the power of His Spirit fall upon our life, and we will rise up beyond the situation, and we can say, my Redeemer lives. Hallelujah. So, there is one beautiful Malayalam song. It goes like that. Devasneham Varnichidan Vakkugal Pora Nandi Cholli Thiruvani Jeevitham Pora. So that was a wonderful song. And to tell the love of the Lord, to explain the God's love, the whole words which exist today in the world is not sufficient. If at all you want to thank, all of your life is not enough to thank. Isn't it amazing? You can, the whole life you take to start thanking God, you cannot thank. Kastapadin kalangali rechikinna snegham ortha sudichalum jeevitham. When I am going to the testing and trial time, the gracing love which delivered me, and how much ever I praise, sarvadum nindanam swasthamayurangida sambathil mayangade. Our life mannil saubhagyam never enough nedana the goodness of God into our life. And the word further went on saying, if you earn the whole world but you lose your soul, what profit? And today, and I believe the word of God touched your heart. And today, as 3 points quickly that we are going to meditate, to become the people who call those things does not exist as they do. Because God want to do a supernatural things through you and me. If you start seeing the invisible thing, and today the God is assuring you, you can do the impossible. Hallelujah. First of all, we need to read and meditate in the promise of God. Hallelujah. So according to Romans 10:17 says, faith comes by hearing the word of God. And today, the world, which is a corporate world or the busy world, you know, the people is very much busy in talking than hearing. And they talk and hear which profits the financial thing that will bring up their position, their status in the social life. But the word of God says, the faith comes by hearing, the hearing the word of God. Hallelujah. Because the chapter, Psalms 119 verse 105 says, your word is a lamp unto my feet and light unto my path. As we are walking in the world, which was so much of, you know, chaos and confusion, you and me will be a light of this world. So we need to have the word of God into our spirit to speak. Amen. So we need to read the word and meditate upon, not hearing, you know, of worldly things and worldly musics and worldly all those things. It is not going to profit. Sometimes even people can justify, saying, you know, even today that movies or whatever we watch, there is a lot of, you know, information. And Google is the one thing I really, God forbid, when the Google will come to stand still. Because people get so much information, more than what they needed. They cannot handle it. And I have seen personally the people come to the doctors to visit. They're already having their pre-consumed or, idea so much so, the poor doctor get really weird out. Now at last, now doctor will be sitting here, the patient will be sitting opposite them. As doctor started speaking, and after one point of time, the patient talks more than the doctor. Now the doctor get confused, who is the doctor? Because he is paid, so he never asks. Literally, he must be thinking, hello, tell me one thing, you are doctor or I am doctor? Because this poor fellow, even nowadays, the Google is so much so, even if you lost something, you can search there, the people say. I never tried. You know, the Google, the search engine is good, but don't trust so much. There are junk also. I tell you a small illustration. When you come out of your house, I think most of our, if not in India, here at least we have trash bin. You know, when I say that only, I remember one good thing. The last time when I've been to India, you know, one of the streets I was walking by, I was so amazed or shocked by the one of the houses, there is a board written, if you put your trash in my place, in our trash, and trash from other place, we will put back to you. Believe me, God is my witness. It is not saying, there is a board. Now you tell me, what should I ask? If you put your trash in front of my house, our trash and other trash we will put back to. What a loving God. The God said, love your neighbor as yourself. You can't love someone with a trash. You know what people today have to offer? Nothing but trash, I tell you. But God want to give a fresh manna. Why settle for the trash? You know, when you come out of house, there's a trash bin. This is the initial story. Huh? This is a sub-story into that. Sorry, forgive me. You know, when you come to the trash, if you try to search, there also some cookies will be there. Isn't it? It will be there, definitely. Or some expired cookies which is unopened. The Pepsi unfinished. But nobody go and take those cookies. Brand new cookies. Huh? Nobody go. Why? We know this is not the right place to eat from. That's the trash bin. That bin discarded. The omitted things. Leftover. The God has called you and me not to go behind the leftover things. Not the trash. You can justify the movie can give me this, the Google can be the search can. Hello, this all the trash maybe. Don't end up in trash. When God wants to give a fresh manna every day from the throne room of grace, why to settle for the trash? That is a good question. That is the big question I want to ask each and every. Why to settle for the trash when the manna comes from ready-made from above? That is going to, you know, encourage you, build you physical, spiritual, financial. Never settle for the trash. If at all someone saying, yes, brother, there also good things are there. And you can very well boldly say, sorry, brother, I never eat from the trash. But at least if you cannot say, you can just speak in spirit. Huh? It's all dependent on the person above you. You know, sometimes when the driver, when you're driving on the road, people's, you know, that strength come depend on who is the other driver. If the driver is weak and feeble, they talk anything. If they see someone is strong, they hold their tongue. We are not called to be like that. We are the destiny changers. We need to make a positive impact upon the people's life. If at all someone speaks negative into our life, we have the authority and power to cancel the word. Because the word of God is divinely deposited into our spirit. And the word says, I am the Lord who called those things does not exist as they do. Hallelujah. So if God can do that, being his children, and so can we do. Hallelujah. And we don't have to be weary, and we don't have to be, you know, disappointed and depressed into our life today what is happening. Sometimes there is a sickness today. Probably after we finish it, we'll go for a time of prayer. And today I believe there is a healing power of God is going to be poured up mightily upon each and every one of us. I will be healed. You know, there is a need. There's a healing touch. The power of God. Today we are longing from his throne room of grace. Hallelujah. And I assure you, as we walk out of this place, our life will never be the same again. Amen. Our God is a mighty. Our God is a strong. Amen. He is a redeemer. Hallelujah. So what we are seeing, the first one is we need to read and meditate upon the word of God. So Romans 10:17 says, the faith comes by hearing the word of God. Hallelujah. To believe what is really happening now doesn't need a faith. If you want to see the invisible thing, that you need a faith. That is why the God has given vision to our beloved pastor. The vision to run the church. Vision to take us to the destiny that God wants us to be. The vision is nothing but what is our vision of Saving Grace Global Ministry? The vision is to equip, evangelize, equip and empower. Three E's. Amen. So when you are planted in the house of God and you will be a part of the vision. So that is why it's very important. We should not be potted, but we need to be planted. So whatever this, the house of God, want to bless into your life, you can be a partaker of that. So if you are, you know, like hopping the church and looking for prophecy and meeting this, you know, when you become a part of many vision, sooner or later you become a television. Don't become. It is a serious thing. Don't be a part of many vision. You will be lost. Be planted in one place where called you to be, where the pure, unadulterated word of God being preached. We need to be planted in that place so that we will be cherished, nourished, and flourished. Hallelujah. So we need to read and meditate upon the word of God to build our faith. So the word of God will build our faith. Amen. So then James 2:17.
Faith by itself, if it is not accompanied by action, is dead.
Amen. And James 2:22.
You see that this faith and his actions were working together, and his faith was made complete by what he did.
The faith without action is dead. So every one of us has a faith, but we will need to step out of our situation and believe in the mighty God. Amen. You see that his faith and his actions were working together, and his faith was made complete by what he did. That's what the Abraham believe in God, that is counted the righteousness. How? Abraham, not only he did not stop believing in the word of God, but he went ahead in action. When God said, leave your own people to move the land where I'm showing, he not only believed God, who calling is a faithful God, but he took the step of faith and put into action, so he obeyed. It's just believing or just having a faith is not sufficient. And the woman with the issue of blood for 12 years, she not only believe that Jesus, when he come by that side, can able to heal her disease, but she step out of faith and put in action by touching at least the hem of garment of Lord Jesus. She know that will be, she will receive the healing. Hallelujah. So having faith is one thing. We need to step up out of our situation and put that faith in action. Hallelujah. As even we will be praying, and wherever the sickness may be, but when you not only believe the God's healing power, but you are, by action, we need to touch where that you have a problem, then you will receive that. Then we can go on saying, go on and go forth. There is a lot of example when we see, not only like Jairus' daughter, when Jesus going to heal. And he said, what? You know that, sorry, the centurions. He said, you don't have to even come to my place. Say a word, speak a word. My servant will be healed. That is faith in action. Amen? So that he is able to see the invisible thing to can accomplish the impossible. The healing not had been accomplished by, for his servant, but he spoke faith in advance. Today, beloved in Christ, you and me may be having a different situation. There is some need you are looking unto Lord, but speak in faith and start seeing the invisible things. Talking about Abraham, he didn't have anything to believe what God has said. The God told him, I will make you the father of nations. Your descendants will be like stars of sky and sands of the sea. Now, at that point of time, till God has given him that promised son, that is almost 25 years, he knows his body is dead, and Sarah, his wife, womb is dead. She passed that age of childbearing. He didn't have anything to believe that promise, but he put that promise, the promise of God in action. Do he believe it? So today, you and me may be having a situation. Can't believe there is a breakthrough can come. Can believe the relation can be restored. Can believe that sickness which has been bothering you a long time can, you know, be healed. You may think also the situation is so stinking. But if you take that step of faith and believe and put in action saying, yes, Lord, I receive that. My family relation will be restored. My sickness will be healed. My children will be obeyed. And if you start seeing, yes, my children are the best children ever possible on the face of the earth. If you believe it, but that come to pass, that's the word of God says. The third thing, the first one, that is we have to read and meditate the word of God. The second, we have to step out by faith and ask as per the God has promised. The third thing, we have to set our thermostat. In the sense, even we have seen in the, you know, there are youth and have been also taught, we are not a thermometer, but we will be a thermostat. Amen. When you come to your house, where you see, you know, the temperature usually it is of, say, 40 degree or 35 degree Celsius. What do? You will put on the AC and setting the temperature where you desire, 22 or 24 or whatever it may be. Now, until you don't disturb, what do the thermostat do? It will not stop. It will keep calling those things is not existing as if they do. Are you getting what I'm saying? The thermostat, when you set, the present room temperature is of 40 degrees Celsius. You set the temperature to 22. Now the thermostat will not stop working until it will reach to the desired temperature. So you and me are the thermostat. But only thing is what you desire. So until unless you don't set the temperature, nothing will happen to that, the climate, or nothing will happen to the temperature. We need to set the thermostat. Today, you and me need to believe the promise of God. And he said, I will neither leave you nor forsake you. And he said, you will neither see the wind nor see the rain, but your valley will be filled with the water. You, your animal, your cattle will be, you know, filled. And I will also give the Ammonite or Moabite unto your hands. Hallelujah. So when you will rise up beyond the situation, rise up by faith, and God is able to do it. Amen. So that we have to believe, and we need to refuse to speak and during the time of waiting. You know, I know the waiting time, ever since God promised you, till you get the promise come to pass, the waiting time is a crucial time. People may speak. When the Noah, by faith, he started building the ark, people must have told, what a foolish fellow this. There is no rain, no water, such a, you know, big ark, and they were doing what they were doing. But the time came, as the God has promised, has spoke to Noah, there were rain and everyone perished except the 8 souls. Hallelujah. That is what. So Noah took the God's word seriously. And he believed that is counted righteous in the eye of the God. And today, even as we, no matter whatever the promise God has made into your life and my life, that will come to pass. But during the time, refuse to speak any negative word. If at all anyone speaking negative word into your life, cancel that word in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. That will work. If someone says this sickness, it may be the doctor or the best of best doctor in the town, but our doctor is a physician of all physician. For him, nothing is impossible. With the due reverence to the doctors. But still, we believe in the report of the Lord. The report of the Lord says, we are healed. We are delivered. We are blessed. We are made whole. Hallelujah. So when you start believing that, refusing to say any negative word, same time canceling every negative word spoke unto our life, and we will reach the destination God has promised us to be. Hallelujah. The fourth, last but not the least. So we need to learn to call those things does not exist as they do. Amen. Hallelujah. So today, you and me, the God is asking, telling that I have given you power and authority to call those things don't exist in your life, but there is a need into our life. Renew our mind and transform our heart, O Lord Jesus, so that we will be the people whose destiny changes, O Lord Jesus. And we know you are raising an army, O Lord Jesus, in us and through us, O Lord Jesus, to make an impact in the people's life, O Lord. And we know the best is yet to come. Father God, once again we thank you. Lord Jesus, we thank you. Loving, sweet, Holy Spirit of God, we thank you. We give you all the glory, honor and praise unto you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you.